like I said, when we went back on Wednesday, we had to elect a Supreme Court justice. And I was talking to some of my colleagues, and some people having it worse than I'm having it. I might have told you that earlier. Wow. I have a colleague, and she come out of church, they done slash her tires. She's got a sunroom on her house, they done shot pellets through the sunroof. So this is...
it's a national problem.
Yeah, it's national. You all know where it started. Yeah. And so what's going to happen is that good people who have a lot to offer, they're not going to put themselves in this position. We as black people, this thing about envy and jealousy, we got to get beyond that. Man. And that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to make people, oh, well, he's up there helping his family, and they're getting this, but nobody really is falling for it a lot, from what I'm told. But we got to get beyond that jealousy and envy, because there are grown men, particularly in Clarendon County. I'm 63 years old. I'll be 64 in September. They're older than me. And they're part of this clique because, you know
why?
Yeah, they are. But what they're telling people, well, we just don't like the fact he never lost an election. That's what they're telling people. They're actually telling people, we got him this time. He might have won. We got him. And it's just jealousy, envy, divide and conquer, crab in the bucket mentality.
Yeah.
And it's been that way since the time we came over here as slaves.
Yeah.
But now what they're doing... they're using us against us. Yeah. And I tell people, I said, you know, it just doesn't make any sense.
I listened to George Orwell in his readings, and I quote, he said, in a time of universal deceit, telling the truth is a revolutionary act.
That's it.
It's sad.
Yeah. It's sad, but it's true.
There is people are really focused on going after the truth. And as you know, like you said earlier, with the Biden administration not getting their messaging out, because the other side is getting a misinformation message out, and they're putting it out 50 times than the things that he's actually doing is positive.
And if you keep hearing a lie, you end up believing it.
And that's the problem. Like I said earlier, there's no issues being discussed. All about is this man, family, and what they're making. I don't care about that. I can care less. Carter, I can care less about that. I want to know what you're going to do in my district.
That's right.
That's all I want to know.
And that's most response they're getting. Yeah. What does that have to do? And I hate to tell them, but I'm going to say it just to pick at them, because the salary they got here for my son is low. It's higher than this.
Hey, I saw that. I said, that can't be right. I said, I know that ain't right.
But he'll say my wife is a district level administrative assistant. Her salary is between $46,000 and $50,000. But he doesn't say she's been in the same position for 34 years.
Wow.
So if this is the kind of person I am, she's not going to be in the same position
that
long. Yeah, she'd be up there, you know. But I don't get involved in that. That's not for me to say. She's satisfied. We're satisfied. None of us are getting rich at all. Now, I have colleagues that are getting rich. I'm not up there for that. We make $10,400 a year as a state legislator, and we get $1,000 a month for expense. So that's $22,400 a year is what we get in our per diem. So we're not making money. When I travel and go to state conferences, my counterparts in other states, now they're actually making a salary. And what I don't like about our salary is that unless you're wealthy, which I'm not, but I'm retired, I have other income. So there are a lot of good people who will make good legislators, but they can't afford, you can't live off that. And I think they keep the salary low so that we won't have other folks running against us.
Exactly.
It's just not. So this whole thing right here is bogus.
And character assassination.
Right, that's right. Yeah. We're going to talk about it. He's got another card out too. And I told him, I said, we're going to go at my last meeting Monday night before the election. We're going to go line by line. Okay. And we're going to refute all of this stuff. Nothing on here is true. And they notice, these people, Carter and Joe and Rosa Dingell, they get up every morning. And you see how hot it is? and they're putting on shirts and ties and running people down. We need you to vote for Elias Carter. Look at what Kevin Johnson is. And that's what they're doing. Everywhere you go, you pass by. We see them all the time. They're all over.
They put all that work in.
China. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's too hot for that.
Right. Right.
Giving out any kind of information.
Yeah. So when he ran in 2012, he got less than 3% of the vote. And when he ran in 2020, the last time, he got about 20%. I got 80%. And so I guess he figured this is a better strategy for him. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Tell the people why it's important to vote.
Well, you know, it's important to vote in every election. Every election.
Regardless, local.
Yeah, definitely local. And I tell you, sometimes it's more important for local races because, like I said, in South Carolina, I mean, with all these elections have consequences. And when you have the wrong people sitting around that table, it affects us in a negative way. I mean, it affects people in general in a negative way. Yeah. You've got to research the candidates, see what they stand for, and the best way to find out what they stand for is to find out what they've already done. And I tell people, just because a farm pedalino come to you and smile in your face and pat you on your back, I said, would you want to know how she feel about you? Go look at her voting record. It's public. Look at what she's voting for. Farm Petalino.
People know who Farm
Petalino. Yeah, she's the current representative. Okay. But Farm Petalino was a co-sponsor of a bill. And what that bill said is that if a woman in South Carolina has an abortion, she's subject to the death penalty.
The death penalty.
Oh, my
now,
Lord.
Now, they're pro-life now.
So that's who y'all voted for.
But she's saying that if you have an abortion, and then what happened was the pressure got on.
She
and a lot
up.
Of them started removing their names from the bill. But you can remove your name from the bill, but that's still in the heart. You want a woman that thinks it's in her best position, or to have an abortion, and now you want her subject to the death penalty. But you're pro-life, but you want to kill the mother.
This episode is sponsored by Events by Sweet Pea LLC, CEO Eartha Mae Hughes. Our mission at Events by Sweet Pea LLC is to provide and create seamless, lasting experience. Our service are impeccable and precise to leave every client with a smile. We will give you a lasting impression as we help your vision come alive. You can contact Eartha Mae Hughes at 803-983-4625. Again, 803-983-4625. And our email address is eventsbysweetpea104@gmail.com. Again, eventsbysweetpea104@gmail.com. Jerome Robinson MMA of Team Robinson MMA, a safe training environment that will enable students of all ages and backgrounds to grow physically and mentally. You can visit their website at www.imteamr.com for more information. If you're interested in being a sponsor, contact myself, Ernest Miller, at 803-565-9752. That's 803-565-9752. Or you can hit me up on my email at eaenestmiller83@gmail.com. Again, that's eaenestmiller83@gmail.com. You can also make contact with my producer, Victor Wesley of Vic West Production. His telephone number is 803-225-0021. That's 803-225-0021. Also, his email address is vicwestp@gmail.com. That's vicwestp@gmail.com.
All right. Look at the bill she's sponsoring. So I saw something the other day, and she must have took a page off of my page, because now all of a sudden she's for education. She's for job, economic development. But look at the bill she's filing.
Yeah. What have you done
in
that case?
So I'm telling you, and she's been there 2 years. And when Kim was there 2 years, it was, she hadn't done anything. But now she's been there 2 years and hadn't done anything at all. Look at it.
Well, let me ask you, I know she ran against your daughter, Kim. Was that her strategy when she ran with the abortion, the people actually went along with that?
Yeah, all of us, all of what Carter's doing now is right on their plate, because you got to keep in mind, it worked for him.
Yeah.
As they figure, we just go and just character assassination and try to make people think he's somebody he's not. But what they forgot about me, probably more so than Kim, is people know me all over the state.
That's what I was about to say.
Anyway, I can't go
Kim
anywhere.
Too, like, people know you
guys. I was in the mall in Savannah, Georgia, in Belk, and I sneezed. I heard my other side That sounds like Kevin Johnson. That was a friend of mine. That was a friend of mine from Buford when I used to live in Buford.
Yes, sir.
And so, you know, so I mean, it's just people know me.
Yeah.
And when people know you, you know, now they may fool some of the people because some people, everybody don't know me, and they might think, you know, oh, this is the kind of person he is. So I don't know what kind of impact it's going to have. But the feedback we're getting is it's not working. And these folks out there every day, they're going to the grocery stores, they're going to Walmart, they're going to people's door to door, they're going to people's jobs with this nonsense.
That's it. And so you obviously have nothing else to give the people misinformation.
And they're criticizing my experience, they're criticizing my seniority. And I said, when you don't have experience and when you don't have seniority, you can make it a bad thing. But it's a good thing. Everybody know that, you know, have nothing to offer. You know, so we feel good about it. And you know, it's not just me. Like I said, when we went back on Wednesday, we had to elect a Supreme Court justice. And I was talking to some of my colleagues, and some people are having it worse than I'm having it. I might have told you that earlier.
Wow.
I have a colleague, and she come out of church, they didn't slash her tires. She's got a sunroom on her house. They didn't shot pellets through the sunroof. So this is
it's a national problem.
Yeah, it's national. You all know where it started.
Yeah.
And so what's going to happen is that good people who have a lot to offer, they're not going to put themselves in this position. They're not going to run for office because it's gotten to be really almost not safe. You know,
toxic.
These people are crazy. I'm telling
right.
you.
Right.
They're crazy.
You should assassinate someone's character, but just think, your character is not a product of your circumstance, it's a product of who you are in spite of where you are. You just keep fighting.
We can keep fighting. You know, like I said, I think we're going to be okay. But if not, just like Kim, when she lost, a lot of people had what they call buyer's remorse because they realized they had done the wrong thing. A lot of them didn't vote because they were so sure she was going to win. But getting back to your question, yeah, everybody need to vote because if nothing more, if you don't want to get involved in these candidates, whatever, honor your foreparents that suffered and bled and lost so much, even their life, so we can have the right to vote. And now it's easy. You can vote early, 2 weeks, everything. And I think it's a dishonor to our ancestors that we won't even take the time to vote. And there have been a lot of elections where people lost by one or two or three votes. So these elections have consequences. And it'd be a sad situation to wake up and realize that the best person in your eyesight lost by one or two votes and you didn't go vote.
Well, Senator, let the people know. We're going to end it. Let the people know how they can get in contact with you.
Yes. So I'm available. People come to my house, whatever, it don't matter.
They do to
my predecessors. They do to me.
Okay.
But anyway, you know, I'm all my information. My cell phone is public. I'll give it to you, 803-410-1253. I'm on Facebook under Kevin Lorenzo Johnson. A couple of days ago, I was out there under Kevin L. Johnson, but these same people, they hacked my account again. They locked me out. And so I'm on the account now that they locked out last year that I finally got opened back up. But just reach out to me anytime. My office number is 803-212-6056. That's what we're here for. If we can do anything for you, feel free to contact us. And if we can't get it done, I promise you it won't be because of lack of effort. I have a contact. A liaison in every state agency. And when folks have an issue with that particular agency, I can pick up the phone and call that person, and I can get that person to call you too. So that's what we're here for. I'm available. I have a landline phone. It's public. It's in the book, 803-435-8117. We just try to be as accessible as we can. So we're not hiding. We're out and open, and I'm just glad to be in a position to do what I do and just, you know, just working hard and having fun.
And remember, guys, y'all listen to the issues, man. Like I always say, you vote for what's going to do good for your family, you and your family. So obviously today you've been hearing the issues. His competitor, you've been hearing slander. You do the math. It's easy. Mr. Johnson, thank you for coming today, sir.
Appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
I enjoyed it.
Yes, sir. Please, guys, subscribe to the YouTube channel. You can follow us on YouTube, The Miller Experience, also iHeartRadio, and also Spotify. See you guys on the next one. Peace.
Make sure you check out the next episode. And also, you make sure you like, subscribe, and comment on my YouTube channel, The Mill Experience. And now we also on Spotify, Apple, and Amazon. Make sure you download. Peace.